turn that music down a little bit. Wow. We're getting into this TikTok. We call it TikTok versus food service. But you know what? I used ChatGPT today, and it came up with TikTok to menu. I thought that's going to
be cool. I feel like the name of the show changes like every day. It used to be called, just so you know, if you want a history of this show, it started off as Real, R-E-E-L, to Real, R-E-A-L. And then it got turned into food service versus TikTok, TikTok versus food service. Now we're what, TikTok to menu?
Well, we can do whatever you want. It's still a part of the SVK network.
You've got me, Chef Richard White, here from Lester's Foods. And, of course, Caleb Borland, my new co-host, breaking him in. Second show, he's with us from Reuven. You know what? Second show, last
second show.
Second show, yeah. I go through a lot of co-hosts. I'm difficult to work with, not going to lie. Yeah, but I am feeling a little bit out of sorts here today. You see this thing? Like, what is this? Let's be honest. Come on. I have the subtle Lester's logo in the back here, a little nod to, you know, and he brings in this billboard on wheels.
So heavy, Richard had to help me carry it in.
Yeah, that's good. Today's show is sponsored by.
Yeah, I was going to say, and let's okay. Thanks for the billboard.
No worries. It's all good. You know, if we could just get a truck to load it on to get it out of here, that would be great. Hey, listen, we have a fun show for you guys today. We actually have a wonderful, fun TikTok challenge. Jay, did you get the email I sent you with the link? Oh, good. All right, good stuff. You know, it's not often that sandwiches and furthermore, deli sandwiches get onto the viral TikTok trend. But you know, we got one, and it's called.
I'm not even sure.
Is this it right here?
This is it right here. What's it called?
The grinder.
Like, if you're gonna have a sandwich and call it the
grinder.
Oh my God! Like, come on! It's great. It's we're calling Caleb inappropriate Caleb today because the grinder jokes that have been going on around here, and I don't mean like salt grinder.
Yeah, we're going to pretend it's a salt grinder, though, Richard.
I don't mean pepper grinder. We're talking sandwich grinder. So the grinder, before we get to the video, I'm going to cut you off. Before we get to the video, the grinder sandwich is like an old, I think it's New York, like whatever, East Coast, USA, immigrant sandwich, like a working man's sandwich. And they would go for lunch and they would get like at the takeout sandwich shop, they would get this sandwich called a grinder. It's kind of been lost in obscurity for a while, but thanks to TikTok and everything that they do, it's been brought back.
It's kind of similar to what you would find at Subway as a cold cut trio.
Subway in New York. He's not talking about the restaurant because that would be absurd. Absurd. It's a great little fun sandwich, and the videos are amazing. I have to apologize to my wife and kids for going down the grinder rabbit hole for like 4 hours the other day. There's so many great videos. It was very difficult for me to actually find the video I wanted to show. I find my favorite videos are in that ASMR category, and this is definitely on the edge of that. She's not fully in the ASMR category, which is very good. So why don't we educate people, and why don't we show them the clip? And it's a 45-second clip. So take your time, relax, grab a drink.
Richard, trivia.
Oh,
why is it called the grinder?
Well, there are some debates about it, but it's because the working man was well, nowadays we use the term hustler. Everyone's got a side hustle. Everyone's hustling. You know what I mean? Back in the day, it was grinding. You would grind out your job. You were a hardworking blue-collar worker. It was a grinder.
Not even close.
I don't think that's the reason. I think, Richard, I'm going to BS on that.
Okay. Yes, on that one.
You had to grind your teeth through the deli meats. I was going to leave that out. You Google it in the background. I know you did.
It was based on the bread. The bread was tough, right? Because it was like that sub. It was you grinded your teeth. There you go. You are definitely great at telling a story. So
yeah, that's a very good story.
That was very good, Richard. Love it, dude. All right, we're gonna.
Yeah. I can tell you, anyways. And I love this video. And just hey, for our viewers, note the cinematography on this. This is TikTok, But like, this is high quality production TikTok. It might take a minute for you to buffer your internal systems and not get your.
Got it here.
I don't have any audio on it though.
Do you want audio? Do you?
Yeah, you need to hear it.
We want the audio.
Oh, okay. A little butter sauce. Oh yeah. It's you're buffering a bit.
Well,
we'll play it twice.
Yeah, no, it's playing good. Do you want to be played twice?
I don't know. Maybe on my end, it just looks fun.
Oh, it looks great. It's
okay. Look at that. Oh, the cheese. Look at that.
That does look good.
That's a beautiful sandwich.
That does look good.
Another day, another sandwich. Yeah, that's another TikTok trend, right? That's your guy. What's his name?
Billy Love.
Billy Love. Toronto, right?
Yep.
This guy's a beefcake. He's like, I got big muscles and you're going to watch me make sandwiches. He's very cool. Anyways, you got to watch him. Billy Love. This is turning into like a podcast, TikTok podcast show, like on CBC. We're talking about other people's work. Great video. Anyway, so the Grindr sandwich, when you break it down, it's a low cost sandwich. It was a blue collar sandwich back in the day. They had to grind your teeth through. I like the Grindr my way better, just so you know. I like the BS story better than the
story. It was believable, Richard. It was
you know, it's all in the delivery.
She may be a four-year-old child, but
yeah, definitely. Every day I'm hustling. All right, so great video. The cinematography on that's great. You know, she shot that in 4K. The transitions are brilliant. The music in the back, just everything. She's a very talented filmmaker, obviously, and showcasing it on TikTok. So what we've got is basically a deli sandwich / salad. All stuck together. Am I going first or you going first?
I'm going first. I'm doing a variation.
So. All right. So he can have that one. All right. So last time I did the variation and he did the real thing and then he got upset with me because I didn't tell him he could do a variation.
So it's my turn this time.
It's his turn this time. Okay. So true to the video. We'll start with the video if I've got it in my head. So she starts with a nice little butter. She makes a nice little compound butter where she hits the butter. She hits a little bit of garlic. Garlic stuck to the dish. She got some parsley in there, fresh chopped. Well, you can't see it. It's in the way. I have the parsley cow in the window. Anyways, a little bit of that.
And that billboard, Richard.
Thank you. The billboard, the truck. So. Can't see anything. Did you know that Reuven is participating in the show today along with Lester?
No, I was like, well, what's this? You don't just have that in your kitchen all the time, Richard?
Yeah, I leave it there.
I'm leaving it here, actually. It's going to stay there.
And for Parmesan cheese today, we're going full Eastside Mario's. Oh, tell me when.
Nice.
Oh, hello, Uncle Roger. Okay, good stuff.
What kind of cheese is that?
Parmesan. Actually, this is Oro Nero from Catch-22, a local food shop around here. They find the best ingredients, and this is like a black rind Parmesan-style cheese. It's outstanding. So she cut her bun in half. And she did that, and she set that aside because I think at the end, she kind of based this together. So we're going to set that aside for a minute. We're going to follow the video, okay? Oh, and she put a little bit of herbs in it, didn't she? She put a little oregano.
Yeah.
Okay, done. Okay, next. Okay, then she made the salad next? Yeah. All right, so she made the salad. So I got the ingredients here. Oh, and the bowl for purposes. Shred the lettuce, very important. Is that chopping loud?
Yeah.
We're like really loud?
No.
Turn up your headphones. Okay. So we got a little of that. You don't want to make it too like thin, because you don't want to be like, you know, processed food thin, but you know, like that. And then she did her onions. And what did she do with her onions, Jay? Do you remember? She soaked them in water.
Yeah, why? Ice water.
Hot chat. Why did she do that?
What did she do? No. Why did she do ice water? I don't have a clue. She gave it an ice.
Cool it down.
No. Like, these are terrible. Because red onions, Bermuda onions, are super, super spicy and pungent. So what she does, soak them in cold water too, make them more mild.
That's what I mean. Cool it down.
Cool down the flavor. Yeah. Okay. I'll give Caleb from.
Caleb, you win that one, buddy.
What's that?
You win that one. You win that one. I didn't know. I had no idea. I saw it though. I did throw ice cubes in there.
I googled it. The tomato. She just cut the tomato. She didn't actually put it on the salad, did she? Okay, I'll just cut this real quick while I got it out.
Richard, is there any other fruits and vegetables or vegetables that say that you can? But ice baths too? It does stuff.
You can ice bath a lot of things. Like when you're blanching, for instance, like if you're going to do some nice broccoli or Brussels sprouts and blanch them, you want to maintain their not only the consistency in the middle, like the texture in the middle, but the color. Yeah, you give them that ice bath to stop the cooking process, but make that color vibrant.
It shocks them, so it stops them from further cooking.
Right, but for a raw vegetable or fruit?
Bring it back to life. Okay, that's cool.
Your parsley in some water. So she did this, and then she made a little sauce with that, didn't she? She made the sauce, and then so she started off with mayonnaise. And if you want a little plug for Cisco branded product, did you work with Cisco? I work for Cisco. Did everybody work for Cisco?
Yes. So what kind of mayo is that?
I'm just using whatever mayo. But like, if you're in a restaurant, don't use normal mayonnaise. Use a culinary mayonnaise. It's higher in protein, and it won't leach out the water. Like the moisture won't come out because it's not full of water. And there's no sugar in culinary mayonnaise, which you don't want sweetness in your recipes for restaurants. All right, a little bit of mustard, and then I got some. She threw her peppercini peppers. She put that in the lettuce, so I'll put that in the lettuce. Oh, and then she had roasted red peppers. Put that in the lettuce. That was good. What else does she have in this thing? Oh, and then she had a little bit of red wine vinegar. Always very good.
And she put a bit of oregano in her actual dressing.
Did she put oregano? Okay, well, we got the oregano here.
And she probably put some of this.
What's that? The Lester's Magic. Oh, chef seasoning. It's a secret. We can't tell you what's in it. She did that. A little bit of parsley. And the parsley pig. Okay, we got that done. And then, of course, the East Side Mario it. Hey, bada boom, bada bing. Okay. And that's how she made her little dressing. So right now we've got a little bit of a salad, we got a little bit of a dressing. This is going to take a long time. I really need a drink. Oh, look at that color, that's beautiful. That's wonderful. So we got all those wonderful ingredients, the red wine vinegar, giving it its color, a little bit of mustard. That's fantastic. Okay, good stuff. So she did that. That was kind of like her setup. And then she did the bun. I need the tomatoes back though. You're telling him what to do now. He works for Ruben. So what did you do with the bun? You put the cheese on the bun.
Cool.
The bread's so important. Yeah, provolone. You know, I don't know how the Italian cheese got into the grinder sandwich, but whatever. It's there. And then she took the little mixture here. Remember our butter mixture from earlier? And she brushed it on the top. She did a great job. That shot in the video was really nice too. Showed all the butter dripping and the herbs and whatnot. That's wonderful. And then, of course, she banged it in the oven. And we're making this in real time, folks. Just so you know, there's no magic of television here. We're actually going to, like, do it in real time. That's going to burn in like 2 minutes, so let's just do that. Okay, while that's doing that, because it's only going to take a second, let's talk about what you put in. And this is why this sandwich, like, food cost fan. Because you can use deli meats, or you do use deli meats for this one. And deli meats are so much cheaper than whole muscle cuts. See the furry eye I just got there? you think he's going to show a whole muscle cut? Because I think he is. Anyways, we'll let him sort out that statement later. You're going to keep an eye on that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, thank you, Chef. Anyway, so what I've got here is, of course, shameless plug, Lester's salami. It stuff's amazing. My God. Smoky, beautiful, awesome, cooked salami. And I got a little bit of capicola, a little mortadella, and a little bit of what they call a prosciutto cotto, which is it's ham that's not smoked. Okay? So these are just really inexpensive deli meats, and that's what we're going to make the sandwich out of. I gave him one task. Can you hear that? Oh, it's gone. Okay. I gave him one task. The Reuven guy. He burnt the bun. Look at that. One task. Anyways, all jokes aside. Okay, so for the grinder, again, deli meats, this is the way you combat food prices right now because Everything's so expensive. Everything's going through the roof. The cheese, the bread, everything's going through the roof. So you want something that's going to make money. So we're going to just lay out a few pieces of meat here.
Yep.
And they, like, in these videos, it's everything. Some people are using prosciutto. Some people are using salami. There's no hard and fast rules here. But I've got a little bit of capicola, like I said, a little bit of mortadella, and, of course, the Lester's Classic. I use the we make an all-beef salami, which is very good. I love it. Fry it up with some eggs. Man.
All salami?
Yeah, we it's not what I'm showing you today. Regular salami. But the all-beef salami is so good. Not only for sandwiches, like that's what people use it for. But, you know, I got some guys down in like Southwest Ontario. They cut it nice and thick, fry it on the flat top, serve it with eggs as opposed to like ham or whatever.
Kind of like a bologna.
But again, a little bit of Lester's Classico salami here. Again, inexpensive, very inexpensive here, folks. Get into this. It's fantastic. And you can just smell it when you walk. It's coming. It's got flavor. Like that's one thing Lester's knows how to do, and it's pack the flavors. And I should get a Lester's billboard. Like, why? I feel like we need a billboard. Anyways, I digress. So what you do is you take your dressing that you made and you mix it with the salad that you made, and you come up with what, in my opinion, is the unique, cool part about a grinder sandwich. That it's wickedly different from anything else because it's like a salad.
Are you tiptoeing again?
I'm like tiptoeing.
When you get on your tippy toes,
your
mic goes. Every time you tip, your mic goes.
Like Jeremy Clarkson, I just swore under my breath.
You keep on the flat foot there, bud.
You know what? It's because, you know, when you work in the kitchen, you've always got shoes on. But I'm here at the Lester's Test Kitchen in my home. And I'm not wearing shoes, so I'm like. Anyways, salad. This is good. Like, look at the colors in there. Can you see that? You got the red onion. You got the red peppers. You get the green lettuce. The peppercinis.
Hey, make the sandwich. I'm starving.
Shut it. And then you pile this on because this is nothing. Lettuce and these ingredients, this is nothing.
Like give Richard a shot. Come on.
Am I running out of time?
We still have another sandwich to make.
We got another sandwich.
Hurry up. Jeez.
Jeez. Sure. Longer one. All right. He wrapped it in paper. I love wrapping it in paper.
See if he, let's see those sandwich days in the old sandwich shop. Pay off.
I don't even know if I'm going to be able to get this into this wrapping. Oh, Lester stickers. Where do we get those from? Can I have one more? Oh, they don't stick to parchment paper very well. That's okay. They don't stick to parchment paper at all. Okay, let's get. Okay. The stickers were a good idea. They don't stick to parchment paper.
You guys have Lester stickers, though?
I do, yeah. I make them up for, like, sample bags and stuff like that.
Nice.
Sometimes when I'm randomly going through a drive-thru somewhere, I'll stick them on the post outside, you know, like with everybody else putting stickers out there. Anyways, look at this. I'm going to bring this right into the camera. This is a microphone. I just brought that in. Look at that. Woohoo!
It's a beautiful sandwich.
Look at that.
Well done, bud.
So you want to know why this is, like, a cost buster? Lots of reasons. One, the deli meat, obviously. The salad. There's nothing in this for cost, right? It's very, very easy. But what's more important is it's not a point of reference for your customer because no one else is selling a grinder. Unless you're in, like, New York. So, and it's a TikTok craze. People are going to be instantly onto this. So you throw this on your menu, like on your special for the daily special or whatever, the grinder sandwich. Half your clientele's going to be like, TikTok. And they're going to order it just based on that alone. And you can charge whatever you want for it.
Have you noticed that, Richard, that you go to stores now and they'll say, I've seen on TikTok. And then I was at a store on the weekend that my daughter said that product, yeah, there was like one left on this huge shelf.
Yeah.
Everything else is still there. She goes, that item was on TikTok, and that's why they're almost sold out.
Yeah.
It wasn't even known that it was on TikTok. People just know. How crazy is that?
Our generation was like, as seen on TV, you know, because you had Slap Chop, you know what I mean? Like, and nowadays, we've got the grinder sandwich. So I highly recommend you do this. Caleb's going to do a variation of this here next. I'm going to take a bite into this. And while he's talking, you'll watch my face and see how good this is.
We need to push it.
Or do we do a commercial?
No, no, we can go right into it, buddy. Go right into it. Let's keep going. Right,
all right, okay. Let's keep it rolling.
So I'm doing a different variation. So I'm going to use one of the products I represent, and it's actually going to be a cowboy grinder. So you don't have to do the Italian style grinder sandwich. You can do your own rendition.
The coffee is inappropriate.
So the reason I'm using calling it the cowboy is in beef. So instead of using sliced deli meats, I'm using our beef strip fully cooked.
What kind of beef is like? Where is that from?
It's an outside round or clawed. So parts of the cow that you actually know what they are. It's a sous vide style cook, so it's very pale when you get it. But I mean, you sear it in a pan with whatever sauce you want. So I'm going to do it a bit different, but still do a rendition of a sandwich that could be cost effective during times like these with inflation. So I'm just going to take this beef, toss it in a pan.
So it has a higher fat content, would you say?
No. This is actually like a lean cut of beef.
Is that lean?
Yeah. It's fully cooked, so you don't have to worry about any shrink, and your cost is the cost. The beauty with this is that it's, whatever you have in the bag is 100% usable product. So I just hit it with some, like a Korean barbecue kind of style sauce.
Oh, yeah.
So Caleb, can I ask you a question? Or maybe Richard too. What's your shrink? If I went and I cooked an outside round.
Okay, so they've done the studies on this. You're going to lose between like 35 to 40% is a good number to kind of equate. So yeah, especially if you do like a slow roast. And depending on the cut, you could lose more or less. So this is 100% usable product. Yeah. So when you look at the price might be more per kilo, but you have to factor in even at 25%, it's still cost effective if you're only losing 25%.
So, Caleb, ideally, I wonder if chefs out there are doing like specs checks on that, looking at what the shrinkage is on their proteins.
Well, it's not only just the shrink, though, but it's also the labor cost, the energy cost. Energy costs aren't cheap. You see your natural gas bill last week? But yeah, like you got to factor that in as well, too. But yeah, no, you definitely, when we do, because we cook a lot of briskets at Lester's, right? So we know. So for you to say somewhere between 25 and 38%, depending on the cut and the fat content, that's accurate.
Another thing is constantly on the whole muscle is you're losing. So every week it changes, right? The price is not consistent. So we can make a commodity-driven item. And the less expensive cuts are going up in price because the demand's higher. So when you get a product like this, I mean, there's different ones you could get. We have shred, ground, or strip. It's a neutral flavor, so you do what you want with it.
Wow.
And the price is consistent, right? It doesn't fluctuate.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm doing a different rendition here. So the beef's going. I'm going to hit a little bit of a coleslaw. So something different than doing the lettuce and tomato and onion. So just have some coleslaw mix here. I have some coleslaw dressing. Keeping it super simple. Give it some spice. Hitting it with some different colored jalapenos that have been pickled.
Yeah, maybe. Cowboy candy.
That's cool.
You like that?
Just for some, a little bit of pop and freshness, some fresh cilantro, not from the parsley pig.
It's a parsley cow. It's a pig, but it's a cow.
And then just give this a good mix.
Do you have a big enough bowl there?
I offered him a bigger bowl just for viewers at home here. Chef Caleb chose the small bowl. I would use a big one.
Teach their own, boys. So just leave that off to the side and let it absorb.
Yeah.
How's the beef, Richard?
Looking good. Smells great. I don't know if it's the beef or the barbecue sauce.
Okay, let's hit it on the bun.
Are you ready?
Yeah, we're ready.
You want me to do this?
Sure, you can do this.
Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah. You know, last time on the show, he put me on the spot to do a few things.
How much beef is that again?
Well, I'm going to say that's 7 ounces.
6-7 ounces, yeah. And then caramelized onions we did ahead of time.
Oh, just that's my favorite smell in the kitchen, caramelized onions going off.
And then to keep with the spice consistency, a little bit of jalapeno Monterey Jack.
Yeah.
Favorite.
It's good. You know, this is a good variation. I like this. I'm glad that you did a variation and I did the traditional.
So should we attempt to melt it or just...
Oh, we're going to melt it? Yeah, let's melt it. Yeah.
Do we have time?
We got lots of time.
Yeah. Let's melt it. Burn it. Yeah. Well, it's his oven, so he knows the hot spots.
That's the thing about cooking with gas. You just never know what you're going to get. Well, I knew what I was going to get with Caleb. He burnt it.
Yeah.
Actually, you know what? It tastes good.
So you're going
to... Go ahead, Jay.
I was just going to say, you're going to throw toppings on after it's melted a little.
Yeah, so I just wanted to melt the beef to kind of absorb some of the caramelized onion. You could also hit the caramelized onion right in the pan with the beef. And, I mean, the flavor could be anything. If you don't want it to be spicy, it could be a neutral flavor, or you could even just do coleslaw. It doesn't even have to have the extras in it. I just wanted to kind of kick it up a notch to give it some spice. People do like a bit of spice in their sandwiches.
Yeah, I do. Yeah, I do.
There you go.
So melt the cheese.
Ooh, it smells good. The jack cheese, the spice in it. Woo, toasty.
And then just hit it with your slaw on top.
You see the colors on that? That's pretty good.
Very good. Very good.
Like it.
And then your bun is still a bit soft, which is nice.
Oh, you're going to do that? You want to play? Yeah. Oh, you need a big plate for that one.
Ooh, I can do this.
Ooh. You're not going to get a wrap it now, Scott. Oh, look at that. Look at both on there.
Now that's a sandwich.
New day, new sandwich.
Packed full of flavor.
Oh, yeah. This is what you're looking for. Guys, come into your restaurant and get that rather than today's chicken club. Like, come on, man. You Instagram that, TikTok yourself eating it, and off you go.
People love handhelds. Things they can eat in their hands. It's like, it's more of a trend.
Love it. Love it. Richard.
Who won?
Awesome stuff.
Hey, you know what? Food costs are getting out of hand. You know, everything's getting out of hand. You know, it's not just restaurant operators aren't just hit with food costs. It's insurance, it's labor, it's rent, it's utilities. Everything's going up. And but we've only got so much that we can raise our menu prices. And so we've got to understand there are other ways to capture cost back. It's just through margin. So it's lowering that food cost, but still elevating the guest experience. That's what we do it. And off you go. And if you're not competing with the same idea as I down the street, like a steak sandwich versus a steak sandwich, then you can only get so much, right? There's a point of reference there. So when you pull a great video from TikTok and you make a great challenge like Grindr, you put that on your menu for the day, it's margin.
Awesome. Thanks again, both of you. I'm not going to say who won. That wouldn't be fair.
It would be terrible. Awesome. I like, that was a good variation of the sandwich. I can't wait to eat it off camera because the beef looks amazing.
Awesome. Well, thanks again, both of you, and enjoy your sandwiches today.
Definitely.
And to everyone else, we're back again next Monday. We have a great lineup of shows every day, Monday to Friday at 3 p.m. Eastern Time on the SVK Network. So thanks again, gentlemen, and to everyone else, have a great rest of your week, and get out there and make a sandwich.
Right on. Your server.
Take care, everyone. Bye.
See you. Bye.
How's your sandwich?